Let's talk about multiplication and division of integers. We'll start with multiplication. Anytime we're multiplying two numbers, the answer to a multiplication is called the product. Now, there are several different ways to write multiplication problems. Let me show you some that you'll be seeing. You may see this. Not too often, though, because we'll be dealing with variables and you're not usually going to see that x or that time sign. More often, you'll see something like this. The dot 4 times 3. Or you may see 4. I call that 4 hugging a 3 in parentheses. When a number is hugging another number in parentheses, it means to multiply. Or you may see 2 numbers hugging each other like that, and that means to multiply. So let's look at this. It says if two numbers have the same sign, the answer will be positive. If I have a 6, a positive 6 times a positive 3, the answer is, as it has always been, a positive 18. If I have a negative 5 times a negative 3, according to this, if the signs are the same on the two numbers I'm dealing with, then the answer is going to be positive. So we have a negative 5 times a negative 3, two negatives. Two negatives come together to make a positive. So we have a positive 15. Let's try this one. Let's say we have a negative 7 times 2. Now, our signs are different between the two numbers, so the answer is not going to be positive. One negative doesn't have a partner to match up to, so this answer is going to be a negative 14. All right? Let's try a fraction. Let's say that we have a negative 2/3 times a positive 1/5. Remember in multiplication, we simply multiply the top times the top and the bottom times the bottom. Well, a negative 2 times 1 is a negative 2. And 3 times 5 is 15. So our answer is a negative 2 over 15, or negative 2/15. Okay, let's try another one. Let's say that we have, we'll say a negative 4/7 times 7/8. Now, I know the answer is going to be negative because I've only got one negative fraction here. And because I don't like to multiply really big numbers, or make numbers bigger than what they need to be, I'm going to get this a little bit smaller by playing what you may call cross outs. Notice that 7 can go into both of the 7s, so I'm going to go 7 into 7 is 1. And I notice that a 4 will go into both of these. So 4 into 4 is 1, but remember that's a negative 1. And 4 into 8 is 2. Now I can multiply top time top, bottom time bottom, and get a good answer, and the answer is going to be negative because I only have one negative between my two numbers. A negative 1 times 1 is a negative 1, and 1 times 2 is 2. So my answer to this problem is a negative 1/2. Okay, let's try a decimal. Let's say that we have negative 2.1 times 0.4. I'm doing this for two reasons. To make sure that you know the answer is going to be negative because there's only one negative number. And also to remind you that when you multiply, you have to add the number of decimal places, the numbers to the right of the decimal for placement of your decimal in your answer. So I know the answer is going to be negative. So I'm going to multiply 2.1 times 0.4. 4 times 1 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. Now, we must look. We have two numbers to the right of these decimals. There's one, there's one. So I'm going to start here at the end and move over two places. The answer is going to be a negative. It is going to be a negative 0.84. All right? Now let's add more than two numbers. I mean, let's multiply more than two numbers. Let's do 2 times a negative 3 times a negative 2 times 1. Well, we can take it two at a time, or we can look and see if the negative numbers each have a partner. And I have two negatives, and two negatives do come together to make a positive. So I can go ahead and declare that this problem is going to have a positive answer. So I'm going to say it's positive, and I'm simply going to multiply. 2 times 3 is 6, 6 times 2 is 12, and 12 times 1 is 12. If you decide to take two numbers at a time, we're still going to end up with the same thing. Watch. 2 times a negative 3 is a negative 6. And a negative 6 times a negative 2, two negatives make a positive, is 12. And 12 times a positive 1 is still 12. All right? I'm going to see if I can fool you on this one. I'm going to make it really big. Negative 5, I think a positive 3, a negative 17, a 0, and an 8. Okay, should we start multiplying, or should we decide if it's going to be a positive answer? Negative 5, negative 17, two negatives come together to make a positive. No, you don't have to do any of that, because if you have a 0 anywhere in the problem, the answer is 0. So let's back up and look at this problem. I'm not about to start multiplying all this. I'm going to step back, look at the whole problem, and when I see a 0 there, I'm going to say, I'm finished. The answer is 0. Okay? Okay, that pretty much covers multiplication. Now let's try some division. When you are solving a division problem, the answer to a division problem is called the quotient. But before we get into actually dividing of numbers, I want to talk about the reciprocal of a number, because we're probably going to be needing that when we deal with positive and negative fractions. The reciprocal of a number is nothing but a flip of the number. Example, if I have 2/3, the reciprocal, or the flip, is 3/2. If I have 1/4, the reciprocal is 4/1, but 4/1 means the whole number 4, so I could just write the number 4. If I have a negative 7/9, the reciprocal is the flip, but it keeps the sign. So it's going to be a negative 9/7. If I have a negative 4/9, then the reciprocal is going to be a negative 9/4. And this is also called the multiplicative inverse, which we'll use later in future chapters. When you multiply these reciprocals, you will always come out with a positive 1 every single time. 2 times 3 is 6, 3 times 2 is 6, 6/6 is 1. When you multiply two negatives, you're going to have 63/63, which is equal to 1. So when you do a reciprocal, if the sign is positive, keep it positive, but flip it. If it's a negative fraction or a negative number, then it remains negative as you flip it. Let's try one more. If I gave you the whole number 5, we know that every whole number has a 1 underneath it. When we're dealing with fractions, we always put a denominator of 1. So if I give the number 5, which is really 5/1, the reciprocal to that is going to be 1/5. Not a negative 1/5, just 1/5. Okay? All right, now let's take a look at some division problems using the very same rule that we've had before. Let's say that we have, well, let me show you a couple different ways to write division to begin with. The first way could possibly be, let's say 4/2. It's written as a fraction, but that line means divide. Or that same problem can be written 4 divided by 2. And the one that we use the very least is the way that you learned in elementary school, 4 divided by 2. So we'll probably be using these top 2 most of the time. Okay? Now, keep it in mind, if the 2 numbers have the same sign, then the answer is going to be positive. If you have different signs, then the answer is going to be negative. So let's try the first one. Let's say that we have 12 divided by a negative 4. We have 1 positive and 1 negative. 1 negative has no match to it, so the answer is going to be a negative. And of course, 12 divided by 4 is 3, but it's going to be a negative 3. If I have a negative 4 divided by a negative 2, according to the rule, if the signs are the same, then the answer is going to be positive. A negative 4 divided by a negative 2 is a positive 2. Let's try it in fraction form. Let's say that we have a negative 27 over 9, which says a negative 27 divided by 9. We have 1 negative, so we know the answer to this is going to be 9 into 27, or 27 divided by 9, is going to be 3, but it's going to be a negative 3. Okay? Now, let's try something. Let's look at that this sign right here again. Remember it says opposite of? Let me show you this problem. Let's say that we have a negative 10 divided by 5. And on the outside we have this, which means what? Tell me the opposite of this. So first I'm going to work the problem. 1 negative here does make a negative, so 5 into negative 10 is a negative 2. But there's a sign out here, and that sign says the opposite of a negative 2. And the opposite of a negative 2 is a positive 2. We saw that not only in division, but we saw it in absolute value, where I put that sign on the outside. We saw it when I was giving you numbers, just numbers like this, with the negative on the outside, saying, change me to the opposite, change me to the opposite. All right, now let me show you 2 different numbers here, or 2 different problems. I have 4 divided by 0, and I have 0 divided by 4. Now, one of these we can do. Another one we can't do at all. I have a little saying called BOE that might be beneficial to you. Let me show you what it means. If you have a 0 on the bottom like this, or if you have a 0 on the outside of a problem, or if you have a 0 at the end of a division problem, assuming that you can write it any of these 3 ways, this cannot be done. These cannot be solved. We refer to these as undefined. Example, if you ask how many zeros in 4, if you say 0, how do you check a division problem? You multiply the quotient times the divisor to get back to the dividend. Well, 0 times 0 won't get me back to 4. And if I multiply by 4, 4 times 0, that doesn't get me back to 4 either. So, if you ever see a division problem written with a 0 on the bottom, a 0 on the outside, or a 0 at the end of the division problem, these cannot be worked. They are referred to as undefined. And so frequently in my classes, when we have confusion about this, I will say BOE. If it's on the bottom, if the 0 is on the outside, or if the 0 is on the end, it cannot be done. Now this one can be done. Let's take a look at it. You know that a fraction has a numerator and a denominator. The denominator says in this problem that I have 4 equal pieces. And how many am I going to let you have? That's correct, 0. That is very possible. And let me show you what it means in the way of a division problem. This says 0 divided by 4. Now, how many 4s are in 0? Here's 0 right here. How many groups of 4 do you see? That is correct, 0. So I put a 0 up here, but look, it will check. 0 times 4 will get me back to 0. And so, if I have 4, and I give you zero, none, then the answer is not undefined. It is zero. Okay, so be on the lookout for that. Let me try a division problem now with maybe some fractions. Let me give you a negative 1/2 divided by 2/3. Now, I don't know if you remember or not, but when we do division of fractions, we do the keep, change, flip. That's why I mentioned the reciprocal. So I'm going to keep the negative 1/2. I'm going to change the division to multiplication. And I'm going to flip or do the reciprocal on the 2/3, which will be 3/2. Now we're ready to multiply. A negative 1 times 3 is a negative 3. And 2 times 2 is 4. So the answer to this division problem is a negative 3/4. Let's try another. I'm going to say a 5/6 divided by a negative 5/6 divided by a negative 1/2. I'm going to keep the negative 5/6. I'm going to change the division sign to multiplication, and I'm going to flip or do the reciprocal on the 1/2, which makes it 2/1. Now, if I want to make it smaller, I can do the crossouts on this, and I think I will. 2 into 2 is 1, 2 into 6 is 3. I'm now ready to multiply top times top and bottom times bottom. Negative 5 times 1 is a negative 5, and 3 times 1 is 3. In algebra, it's okay to keep it top heavy. We don't have to change it into a mixed. If I needed to reduce it, I would, but this is fine like it is, a negative 5/3. So we've learned how to do multiplication and division of signed numbers today.